So now coming to the next slide, as you can see here, this is my wireless access networks. So what we are going to do in this wireless access networks, it can share the wireless access network through your end system to the router. So the thing is that you can see this is my router, and all these devices, who is known as your end system? The laptop, the mobile phones, or anything else like that which is connected with your router, that things is known as your end system. And all these things has been connected here, as you can see in the like diagram. Here I have been connected with my wireless router, and in this wireless, all this my laptop and like mobile phone has been connected wirelessly. And this base station is also known as your access point. And here you can see this wireless local area networks. Now, why it is called as your local area networks? Because this router will have some of the bandwidth where it can connect only that many, devices. If you will go beyond that, the devices will not get connected. So, and also it is going to provide you the Wi-Fi connection as 802.11. So more detail in 802.11, we will study in our next module. For the timing, you remember this is 802.11. What is this BGN? I will clarify you in the next class. And what will be our transmission rate? The transmission rate will be 1154, 450 Mbps. There are various transmission rates are available. Depends on which kind of routers you are buying. So this is all about your wireless local area networks. So one more is like wide area cellular access networks. So what is that wide area cellular access network? It is going to be provided by your mobile or any of your cellular networks, which will be up to your 10 kilometers. Because in your WLAN, in that, it will be only the bandwidth, the connection rate will be 100 feet. But here it will be up to your 10 kilometers. So it is going to have the 10 Mbps of data, and it can have the 4G cellular networks, and nowadays 5G is also available. So all these things, cellular networks, it is going to connect. So now we will have one more thing as your enterprise network. So what is now this enterprise networks? This is also comes under your one of your access networks. All these variety of networks you have to remember, because maybe you will get one question of 6 marks. This is only for the 6 marks question, where you are going to explain about the access networks and the variety of networks which is going to be provided for your access networks. Let's see what is the meaning of our enterprise networks. Here you can see the routers are there. Just you remember the lines and the diagrams, that is very much important. The round one with the cross mark will be your routers. The square box with the cross one will be your Ethernet or switch. Okay, so now, because sometimes you will get the diagrams, and from the diagram you have to think what will be the, like how the code you are going to write, or how you are going to write the programs, you have to think in that way. So here you can see I have been connected with my Ethernet switch, and here the wireless device router has been connected with three systems, and here with this Ethernet the wired laptops has been connected. Here this Ethernet has been connected with my, let's take it as institutional router. So now this has been connected. So now what is the, why it is called as enterprise link? Because this enterprise network is connected with two Ethernets, and one Ethernet is providing the data with the wireless laptop, for the wireless laptops and also for the wired laptops. And one more Ethernet is providing the providing the data values for the servers, which will be present inside the institutional web servers. So one is providing the data for your web servers, and another one is again connected with your routers and has been connected. In this way, you can connect multiple of routers into your Ethernet or into your switch account, no problem in that. Where we are going to use this kind of enterprise network, we are going to use this kind of enterprise network in the companies, in the universities, or in the college, or in the school, everywhere. Whatever the networks you are seeing in our college itself, that is also a enterprise network. So what all are the things are there inside your enterprise network? It is a mixed version. What all are the mixed version here? You can see wireless, you can see wire, you can see many switch, Ethernet has been connected, you can see the routers has been connected, you can see the servers has been connected. Where the it will be mixed version of all these things is known as your enterprise network. And also it will have some values. The Ethernet, the transmission rate with your wired values will be 100 Mbps, 1 Gbps, 10 Gbps, it depends. And on your Wi-Fi, how many access points it is going to give? It is a one access point, okay? You can give 11 access point, 54, 450 Mbps. It will give all these variety of access points. Okay, so now this is all about your access point networks.